The next day, they meet with the migrants again to discuss the exact location of the tunnel and how to cross it. The immigrants warn them that the whole area is controlled by the cartel, and only the mules can cross it. The entrance to the tunnel is near an old abandoned car. Matt plans to put a dent in Manuel Diaz's wallet. So they surveil the potential mules working for Diaz and catch them with the money and deposit receipt. They then freeze the accounts used for money laundering to create the desired effect. Manuel gets the news about the bust. Kate and Reggie go to a local bar to relax, where Kate meets Ted, who is a Phoenix police officer. While they hang out in her room, Kate notices that Ted has a bracelet identical to the one found on the mule. She realizes that Ted is dirty and tries to get her gun. He attacks her from behind and tries to choke her. Meanwhile, Alejandro arrives there and points a gun at Ted's head, allowing Kate to break free. The cartel guys have seen Kate inside the bank and sent Ted to take care of her. They interrogate Ted to find out how many police officers are working for Manuel Diaz. Matt's team locates the old abandoned car near the tunnel entrance. They are waiting to confirm that Manuel Diaz has been summoned to Mexico. They plan to enter the tunnel from the US side and go to the Mexican side while clearing any hostiles. From the drone footage, they see Manuel get in his vehicle with a briefcase, and it appears that he has been summoned. Meanwhile, in Juarez, a police officer is transporting illegal narcotics on his police vehicle. Manuel's vehicle is seen crossing the border and heading for Juarez. After arriving at the tunnel entrance, the team does a quick briefing and gets ready with night vision goggles and thermal cameras. At first, the Delta leader enters the tunnel and silently eliminates any hostiles he comes across. Once they are at the center of the tunnel, the Delta leader fires a few shots to draw the cartel fighters, and the rest of the team moves slowly through the tunnel. Matt also joins the firefight. While moving, cartel members fire at Kate and Reggie, but they handle the situation quickly. However, one of the bullets hits Kate's firearm and damages it. Matt and the Delta team are now advancing on the cartel fighters. Meanwhile, at the other end of the tunnel, the police officer and a cartel member are unloading the narcotics that were picked up earlier. They both hear gunshots coming from the tunnel. The other man quickly points a gun at the officer and asks for his car keys. Suddenly, he gets hit with a headshot, and it comes from Alejandro. Alejandro takes the weapon from the police officer. The officer seems to recognize him and calls him Medellin. At the same time, Kate comes from behind and points her secondary weapon at both of them, asking Alejandro to move away from the officer. Alejandro fires two shots aimed at Kate's vest. He goes to her and tells her never to point a gun at him. He tells Kate to go back and join Matt, and then he and the officer drive away in the police car. Alejandro calls the command center and verifies that they are able to track his location. The command gives him a GPS location for the target. Alejandro tells the officer to drive to Highway 56 in order to intercept the target. Meanwhile, Matt's team secures the tunnel and reaches the other end. Kate comes out angry and confronts him about Alejandro's role in the mission and why the officer was calling him Medellin. Matt tells her that Medellin refers to a time when one particular group controlled the drug trade, with a measure of order that the U.S. could control. Since a decent number of the population will use drugs anyway, the best America can do is to maintain order, using local help in Mexico. Alejandro works freelance with anyone to return that order, while looking for the people who killed his entire family. Meanwhile, after arriving at Highway 56, Alejandro checks with the command to confirm the target car before them. He tells the officer to turn on the siren and pull over the target car. The officer does exactly as he is asked and stops the other car. The man in the other car draws a handgun. Alejandro tells the officer to use the microphone and tell the other man to get out of his vehicle. Alejandro again orders the officer to tell the man to raise his jacket and drop the pistol. After the pistol is dropped, Alejandro tells the officer to get out of the car. The man they stop is Manuel Diaz. While he is figuring out what is going on, two shots fired by Alejandro. One hits the officer, and the other hits Manuel in the knee. Alejandro tells Manuel to take him to his boss Alarcón's house. Alejandro uses Manuel as cover, and then takes out the guard at the perimeter. Upon arriving at the main entrance, the guards see Manuel bleeding. Without any delay, several bullets are fired from the shadows and all the guards are eliminated. The house is monitored from the command center, and they tell Alejandro the number of hostiles remaining. He starts clearing the house, but does not harm the kitchen staff. Alejandro then approaches Alarcón, who is ultimately responsible for his family's death. He confronts him for a bit, then finishes him off. A few days later, while standing on her balcony, Kate hears someone entering her room. She goes inside and finds Alejandro. He tells her not to stand on the balcony for a while, because there might be cartel snipers looking for revenge. He asks her to sign a mission report, which states that the operation was conducted following every law. Kate is hesitant to sign at first, but Alejandro convinces her to sign by applying a little pressure. He again tells her that the enemy they are facing requires an unconventional approach to deal with, which sometimes justifies bending the law for the greater good. Meanwhile, across the border, while normal civilians go about their daily activities, they witness the everlasting cartel violence and gang activity.